one of the often overlooked elements of Skagit casting is an often overlooked part of Skagit casting is soaking the anchor. And that means when you set your anchor, you wait for a second or two, 1001, 1002. That's why it's called the sustained anchor method. One of the things it's called, because you're letting your anchor soak, you're letting your fly and your sink tip set in a little bit, soak in and sink a little bit. And that gives you more grip when you're peeling your line and forming that D-loop with that big, fat, heavy Skagit head. Skagit head, just the weight of it alone is overpowering. You have to soak. If you don't soak, then you have to peel really slow, it seems like. Or the other, say you can't soak it because you're in really shallow water. The other option is to set the anchor and then sweep, and then wait right here. Let it soak in a little bit at the back cast before your forward cast. So if you're, when you're casting, if it doesn't quite sound right, like it sounds like something weird is happening, you can feel or hear the way your fly is leaving the water. You're kind of blowing anchors, but kind of not, you're really not sure. It might help you to soak that fly after you set it, or soak, or let it build your D-loop and let it dig in a little more before your forward cast, and that might help you. All right, so I'm casting this little beadhead woolly booger. And even a little beadhead, just your basic woolly bugger, if you allow it to set and soak in just a second or two before you cast it, it's amazing how that will dig in, and that will help you, it'll prevent you from blowing anchors. And the problem is that where you recognize it, if you're standing in shallow water, you let it soak for a second, sometimes it'll actually hook the bottom, which is a royal pain. So you can't soak it. So the alternative is to make up for that in another part of the cast. So you might have to sweep super slow. Don't worry about a fancy dynamic D-loop. Just get a D-loop and that heavy Skagit head takes care of the rest of it. The other thing is you can, like I said before, sweep, pause, half a second, and then cast, and that'll help it dig in so you get some purchase when you cast. So I let it soak right here, then I sweep up, pause, and forward stroke. Here, I didn't soak the anchor, but a sidearm cast bailed me out. With a short Skagit head, sometimes just setting the fly beside you and then wiggling the rod till you get a D-loop is enough sweep to get a decent cast. Okay, I was having trouble with that cast because I wasn't soaking my anchor. I'd like to let them soak a second. So set the anchor, let it soak for just a second. Problem is the water is so shallow here and it's deep on the other side, so I can't let it soak after I set the anchor. So what I'm doing is I'm sweeping and then waiting for a split second up here. You still got plenty of time for your D-loop to hang out. And then I'm hitting it. I'm having a better anchor. I got a short mono leader. It's like 6 or 7 feet. But when I pause and don't creep forward, but just stay here, get my casting angle and then cast, the anchor grips good and I get that high line speed cast.
That's cool.
I got 5 feet overhang. Lots of overhang, wait for that D-loom loop just to, you got a long window of time. There's no rush to pound your forward cast. Just let that D-loop set up. You got a big, huge fly and a heavy sink tip, that might not work too good.